Hey everyone, this is Dale here. I am the Digital Marketing Manager for CurrentWare. In today's video, I'd like to show off the new user activity data dashboards that were introduced to BrowseReporter in version 6.0.2. With these dashboards, you can review the productivity levels, web browsing, application usage, and bandwidth consumption of your entire workforce from the convenience of a web browser. These dashboards work in tandem with BrowseReporter's computer activity reports to provide valuable insights into how technology is used in your organization. Today's video is just a sneak peek at what BrowseReporter is capable of. As time goes on, you can expect to see further enhancements and data points added to these dashboards. To begin using the new dashboards, simply select the groups or users you want to review, then select the desired time period. Here at the top of the overview dashboard, you'll see a comparison between the data from this period and the previous time period. This gives you a high-level glance into whether the given metrics have increased or decreased during this time frame. Below that, we have graphs showing the top 5 most used websites and applications. This shows you what computer activities your users spend the most time on. Next, you'll see the top 5 most active and idle users or groups. BrowseReporter automatically switches from active time tracking to idle time tracking when the user stops using their keyboard or mouse for a set period of time. This threshold can be changed to fit your organization's needs. Let's drill down even further by clicking on one of our groups. In this group sub-dashboard, you can see the most productive and unproductive users in the group, along with a dedicated activity log. Likewise, if we started out looking at a specific user rather than a group, we would be taken to a sub-dashboard with that specific user's online status and computer activity data. The activity log lets you review the raw data that is used to populate the dashboards. You can use the search function to find specific information, use the column menu to adjust what columns appear, and sort the data that is displayed. What data points are available in the activity log will vary depending on the dashboard you're viewing. For example, here in the overview dashboard, we have access to group or usernames along with several active and idle time metrics. In the productivity dashboard, we'd have access to the group or username, the number of users, and various productivity metrics. Likewise, the activity log of the website's dashboard shows domain names, active time, web content categories, and the productivity categorization for the domain. The activity log of the applications dashboard shows the application name, process name, active time, and idle time. To finish things off, let's take a look at the dashboards offered in version 6.0.2. Switching over to the productivity dashboard, you'll see how much time was spent on productive, unproductive, and neutral web browsing. You'll also see who the most productive and unproductive users or groups are, as well as the top 5 websites and categories. What is considered productive can be customized by going to BrowseReporter's productivity grading window. A shortcut to this can be found in the dashboard settings. From here, you'll be able to specify whether a given website category or specific domain should be labeled as productive, unproductive, or neutral. Moving on to the website's dashboard, you'll find the total active time and idle time for the selected groups or users, the top 5 websites and most active users, as well as the web browsing activity log. In the applications dashboard, you'll find similar graphs showing you how much time was spent using applications, the top 5 most used applications, the 5 users that spent the most time using applications, and the application usage activity log. Finally, we have the bandwidth usage dashboard. Here, you'll be able to see who is using the most bandwidth and how much bandwidth was used each day. If you'd like to see what websites are responsible for anomalies in bandwidth usage, you can run BrowseReporter's bandwidth usage by URL report. This report will show you the exact websites that are consuming bandwidth. From there, you can decide whether the bandwidth hogs need to be blocked with browse control or if other corrective measures need to be taken. Ready to boost operational efficiency, employee productivity, and endpoint security with advanced awareness and control over how your employees use technology in the workplace? Get started today with a free trial of any of our software solutions. Simply visit currentware.com/download to try our software for yourself, or get in touch with us at currentware.com/contact. Thank you.